today I will tell you about the principle of Davison-Jerwin experiment. This experiment is concerned with the verification of the matter waves associated with the moving electron beam. So if the matter wave is associated with the particle, then it must be diffracted by the atomic planes in the crystal. So this is the idea went this experiment to have the demonstration of matter waves. This experiment gives the demonstration and verification of matter waves associated with accelerated electron beam. The matter waves must be diffracted like X-rays diffraction. As demonstrated by WL Bragg. So if they are matter waves, they must be diffracted. And this diffraction is very similar to the X-ray diffraction as demonstrated by the WL Bragg. So these waves are diffracted by the atomic planes. These waves are diffracted by parallel atomic planes in the nickel crystal. So they are like this, that suppose these are the atomic planes, this I am showing you, this is one plane, this is now second plane, this is now third plane, So these are the planes, and the distance between them is d. This is now your d. This is now interplanetary spacing, and this is now capital D. Capital D. This is capital D. The distance between the consecutive atoms in the plane. So this is now first plane, second plane, third plane. Now let the wave is incident like this on it, and it is diffracted. Another wave. Let this angle is phi and this angle is theta. This is now theta. This is the atomic lattice. Atomic lattice. Atomic lattice. So incident ray, this is the diffracted ray. This is the angle of diffraction. This is the angle of incidence or angle of incidence or the simply the glancing angle. This is the glancing angle, theta. Incident. Rays. And these are diffracted rays. Diffracted rays. So now let this phi equal to diffraction angle theta equal to glancing angle of incidence. And let small d is equal to interplanar spacing in atomic lattice. And capital D, the interatomic spacing. In atomic plane, this is now one atomic plane, this is now second atomic plane, this is the third atomic plane. So distance between these two atoms, this is called the capital D, this I mentioned here. This is now small d, interplanar distance, this is also small d. These are parallel and equidistant. By Bragg's law. What we have? This d sin phi is equal to n lambda. N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is an order of diffraction. N equal to 1, 2, 3,
and so on. This is the first order diffraction, second order diffraction, third order diffraction, and so on. So first order diffraction means that the rays are being diffracted from the first plane. N equal to 2 means diffraction from the second plane. N equal to 3 means diffraction from the third plane. Like that. So this is the order of the diffraction. Lambda the wavelength of the rays. Or this can also be written as d sine 90 degree minus phi upon 2 equal to n n. So taking that n equal to 1, now first order diffraction for first order diffraction. N equal to 1. So when n equal to 1, then we have this 2d sin theta. This now becomes your 2d sin 90 degree minus phi upon 2 equal to lambda. Now this is the experimental value of lambda. It is experimental value. Value of lambda. Now then, there is the theoretical value. De Broglie wavelength for accelerated electron lambda e equal to 12.27 upon the square root of v angstrom, where v equal to accelerating voltage, So these two values, now this and this, the experimental value and the theoretical value must be in good agreement, then it will show that they are the existence of matter waves. The theoretical and experimental value of lambda must be in good agreement. To prove the existence of matter waves. So this is what? That if suppose this lambda e, the de Broglie wavelength, and one the lambda obtained by the experiment, that these two values must be in good agreement. Only then we can say that this is the proof of the existence of matter waves with the
accelerated electron beam. So this is what the principle of this Davison-Germer experiment. So you like, share and subscribe the video. Thank you very much.